Hello friends, happy 2022. In this video, I am happy to bring you my 21 best purchases of 2021. I'll share with you if I have any regrets, if anything had any cons, and the things that I would most definitely buy again. I'm going to be showing you three categories, so handbags, shoes, and jewelry. So we're going to go through all of them from the first item down to 21, and also share with me what your favorites are. For a lot of these items, I have unboxed them with you, so if you are looking for further details like pricing, how much they fit, etc., just go back to that video where you'll see the full details. I will link them all in the description box and make it easy for you. So welcome back to my channel. My name is Jody. On this channel, I talk all about luxury items like the ones I'll be showing you today, as well as document my sister lock journey. I'm happy to have you here. I hope everybody is healthy. I know things are crazy right now, so I hope you're doing well and that you're healthy and that you're optimistic about 2022. I'm wishing you all of the very best. Just remember to be a better version than you were last year. Don't compare yourself to anyone else. All you need to do is be better than you were last year and become the best version of yourself. All right, guys, let us go ahead and get started. First category we're going to look at is handbags. All right, so my number one favorite bag of 2021 is probably the favorite bag I've ever purchased in my whole life, and that is my Louis Vuitton bum bag. This bag, I didn't expect that I was going to love it so much, but I have not put it down since I bought it. This is my everyday bag, the one I wear almost every single day. Prior to this, I was using my Neverfull, but the thing with the Neverfull is I would be carrying around things I did not necessarily need. And so with the smaller capacity of the bum bag, I only carry what I need, and it's so convenient. And as a mom, I have my hands free, and it's super chic. I can carry it across my chest, I can carry it across my back, also carry it as a belt bag. Definitely go check out the video where I unboxed and did the review to get more details. At the time of purchasing this, it was $1,760. Thank you to those of you who reached out to my essay. He told me that he has received a lot of inquiries and purchases, so I'm so thankful to you guys for supporting him. But love, love, love this bag. Has a little zipper on the back and another like compartment right here. So my favorite thing in addition to that is just the color scheme. While I do not enjoy monogram in a lot of brands or like the logo effect, I absolutely love it on Louis Vuitton because my favorite colors are brown and gold. You can see like what I'm wearing today. This is the kind of color scheme that I enjoy wearing a lot, like even my hair, right? So that's why I really like the monogram in Louis Vuitton. I just love the colors. But I feel like if you purchased a bum bag from any other brand, it would still be a wonderful purchase because this bag is so useful and so practical, and it is so resistant to wear and tear, and it is just such an awesome, awesome everyday bag. I'm happy I purchased it. I'd be happy to purchase another one if this one ever got worn out, and I'm so glad I have it. The strap has become a little bit worn. You know, you can see like the leather has worn in a bit because I wear it so much, but I don't mind. It has that lived-in feel to it, and I love it. I enjoy it. Moving on to bag number two. All right, so my second favorite bag of 2021, or second favorite purchase, is my Chanel Maxi in caviar. Let's take a look at her. So this is my Chanel Maxi. It is in the caviar leather. I also have a video where I did a what's in my bag where I gave you more details on this item. But if you have been following the Chanel price increases, I purchased this one in February 2021 for $8,000, and they are now $10,000. So already I've increased in $2,000 on the price, and I'm very excited about that. This bag is so chic. It is so beautiful. It can hold so much. I love to use it as my travel bag for when I'm not traveling with Riley and I just want to look a bit more chic. I also like to just carry it around for my errands and so on when I want to have like a more elegant feel. But I love this bag. It is a keepsake, a forever bag in my collection. And I'm so, so happy that I bought it, even though at the time it seemed like a lot of money to spend. But love this bag. All right, guys, this is bag number 3. It is my Chanel 19. This color, I think, is called brown. This is so beautiful. I unboxed it with you as well, so get more details by checking out that video. But this bag is so beautiful. It is very resistant, not as resistant as the Chanel Maxi in caviar, because this calfskin leather is softer, and so it can get a little bit dimpled. It can get like little indentations on it, so I have to be more careful with it. Even though it is a less expensive bag, I have to be more careful with it than with my Chanel Maxi. But I super love it. The handles have been very comfortable to wear. I love that they have the leather under here. The mixed metals have been very enjoyable to style. And I just love this bag. Also, if you're following me on Instagram at Jody M. Mosley, just like my YouTube, you'll get to see me like in action wearing these on like a day-to-day basis. But this was number 3 favorite bag. This color is very, very hard to get. I purchased it for $5,700. I ordered it in February and I didn't receive it until I think October. So that's why it's very important to me to shop early in the year, because for you to get the things you want, you know, you really have to start the hunt. But love this bag. So this is handbag number 4. It is my Chanel flap bag in ruthenium with sequins. Guys, this is such a gorgeous bag. I got it in December of 2021, so one of the later purchases that I made, but it quickly became one of my favorite handbags. I enjoy styling it. I've already worn it several times. There is a video where I unboxed this with you. I wore it to that party. I also wore it to New Year's Eve, and it's been so great to style. It's such a gorgeous handbag. My favorite thing about it is the way that it sparkles, and it's just a classic Chanel flap. It's so, so easy to get into and everything. It's gorgeous. I'm so happy it's in my collection. I would absolutely buy it again. At the time of purchasing, this was $5,400, and I super love it. It's the most festive bag that I own, and I'm so glad that it's in my collection. All right, friends, my 5th best purchase of 2021 goes to my Chanel 19 card holder. She is so cute. So I unboxed this with you in my 1,000 subscriber video. It's just a cute little card holder with, let's see, 1, 2, 3 slots, and then the middle slot, which is where I like to put cash. But it's really pretty. It's in this dark brown color. At the time of purchasing, it was $500. I have used this a lot. Because, you know, a lot of my handbags, especially the Chanel ones, they don't have card slots on the inside. They just have that zippered pocket. So this has been a great way for me to put just the cards that I need into a smaller case and just carry this in the handbag. And it's so pretty. I absolutely love it. Definitely one of the best purchases that I've made. All right, friends, it is time for the shoe category. I have 13 pairs of shoes to share with you. I know. So while I'm not an impulse shopper, and while I plan everything that I buy for the most part, and while I have a wish list, shoes are my weakness. Now, jewelry is my number one love in terms of things that are logical and like beautiful, right? Mm-hmm. Handbags, I love, but I'm very practical about my handbags. I only want X number and all of that, but the shoes have my heart. I just enjoy shoes, always have. I used to wear my mom's heels when I was a little girl. I just love shoes. So anyway, I have 13 pairs, and let's just get started. Item number 6. This was a great purchase. These are my Chanel sneakers. I have a video unboxing that you can go and watch and like get the full details, but these are so beautiful. I have worn them multiple times. I like them as an airport shoe. I love them as an errand shoe. I love them to make a dressy look a little bit more casual. I like pairing it up with my Chanel bags. Just whatever. These shoes have been a great addition to my collection, and I've enjoyed wearing them. item number 7.
So these are items 7 and 8 on my 2021 best purchase list. I've enjoyed wearing both of these Chanel sandals. I purchased them both in February of 2021, and I'm glad I did because they were completely sold out by the summertime came around. But, and I have a video detailing these as well, so you can go there to like see me try them on and so on. But I've worn them both multiple times. This was like my quintessential beach shoe. Like almost every picture I have of me at the beach, I was wearing this. So, so cute. And then these are kind of my more dressy sandals as well. And I just love them both. They're absolutely wonderful purchases, and I'm so excited that I got them. All right, friends, quite obviously, I was having a Chanel year in 2021, but item number 9 are my Chanel espadrilles. I've worn these at least 3 dozen times. I don't even know how often I wear these. I bought them in February as well when I did my big haul. Also, there's another big haul coming up. I'm going to share with you my wish list. I'm filming it right after this, and then I'm going to purchase some of the things and I will do another haul with you. Well, not really another. I was not on YouTube at the time of doing this haul last year. But anyways, I'm going to share that haul with you. So definitely subscribe, hit your notification bell, and look out for that. But these espadrilles are exceptionally comfortable. They're very, very resistant. So you can see they're not like scuffed up or anything. They're still in brand new perfect condition, except for the back here where they're a little bit bent, but that's okay. These are wonderful. They work really well for days when I'll be on my feet for a long time or when I'm traveling, but I want to be wearing a closed-toe shoe. So yeah, I really like these Chanel espadrilles. Okay guys, let's talk chunky heels. Items 10 and 11 were actually the first video I ever did on YouTube. This was my first upload. I unboxed these for you. The Louis Vuitton Coastline Sandal and the Christian Louboutin Sandal du Desert. Love both of these shoes. Unfortunately, I've only worn this one twice. I don't know how that happened. But I've worn the Louis Vuitton ones countless times, maybe at least a dozen times. If you look at my Instagram, I have tons of pictures wearing these. They're so beautiful. I really like this kind of a, what do you call this? I think it's made out of raffia. But anyway, it is a beautiful shoe. I've worn it a lot. And then this is a beautiful shoe as well. I just did not get to wear it as often. And the Sandal du Desert of 2022 is a different pattern. And I really, really like this pattern better. So I'm glad that I got this one. It has like one kind of a houndstooth on the back. But then it's striped right here. And then it has this beautiful floral satin on there. Such a gorgeous shoe. Absolutely love both of these. And they are very comfortable. And they are both very resistant. Those are two things that are important to me when I'm classifying a purchase as best. Okay, guys. Items 12 and 13 I also unboxed with you. These are in the video where I did a shopping vlog. This is a Christian Louboutin Spica Queen. It's in the clair with the kind of a silver iridescent heel. Despite only getting, I think I got these in, was it October? September, October? September. Because, yeah, I wore these when I went to Napa Valley. But I have definitely worn the Spica Queen several times, maybe about 6 times or so. I love them. They're comfortable. This is one of the best Louboutins that I own. And then the Aquazura Boudoir heel. It is a beautiful heel. It is very comfortable. I've only worn it twice though, so I've not worn it as frequently as I have worn the Spica Queen, but these were also two great purchases of 2021. All right guys, item number 14. We have my Balmain Romy boots. These boots are so gorgeous. Now, if I'm being honest, when I first started to wear them, the bottoms felt very, very heavy. And they are moderately heavy because they're heavier than like my Louis Vuitton boots. But these boots are just so, so gorgeous. Again, these are my favorite colors. I love anything brown and gold. And so I've worn them several times already. They are very fun for me to dress up and to style. This section of it, the canvas, does get a little bit dirty. So I have actually cleaned the canvas part with stain remover before. But other than that, they're a beautiful shoe. And now that they are worn in, they are super comfortable to wear. Okay, so number 15 is the Amina Muwadi Zula Crystal. I have also unboxed these with you, so you can check out that video. But they're so gorgeous. This was my favorite shoe when we went to Sarasota. They were also a favorite shoe when we went to Napa Valley. They're so gorgeous, and the way the heel flares makes them absolutely comfortable. This is a shoe you can wear an entire night. You can dance in. You can wear them in the daytime or in the nighttime. You can dress them up. You can dress them down. This was a fabulous purchase, and it's one of my favorite shoes in my collection. So items 16 and 17 are both from Amina Abdul-Jilil. This is the rose open toe. I love these shoes. I wore them only one time though. I wore them to, I think it was a wine tasting here in Atlanta, but it was a 2-hour event. We were standing the whole time. It was at the wine vault. They have like lots of art and so on. So we were checking out the art, having kind of a social event. And to be honest, they were a little painful. The straps, great, but the bottom would have been more comfortable if it had a higher what do you call right here, the words are missing me right now, but if this was a bit more stacked, it would have been great. A platform, right? If it had a bit more of a platform, they'd be more comfortable, because what was happening was the ball of my feet were hurting so bad, like through this, you know, it's not padded and cushioned enough, and so that's where the pain was coming from. But when I tell you compliments, people were coming up to me from across the room, or I could see girls like elbowing each other or just coming to me straight up and saying, hey, where did you get your shoes? We absolutely love them. I would do anything for a pair. Like, the whole night was all about my shoes nonstop. And then Amina Abdul-Jilil came through with these crystal rope heels. You guys have seen me wear these. How often did I wear these? I just got them, but I've already worn them. Oh, I only wore them once. I feel like it was more than that. But anyways, just bought these. I wore them on New Year's Eve, and they were like the highlight of my outfit. I absolutely adore them. They are very comfortable on like the rose open toe. They are a little bit of a lower heel, and they're a bit more cushioned. And these are some fabulous shoes. You should watch the video where I unboxed and tried them on. Let's hear it for item number 18, our last pair of shoes today. Listen, kind of like the bum bag, this is one of the best purchases I've ever made in my life. These are the Jimmy Choo Bing Flats. They're so fabulous. They're fabulous. They're comfortable. They are pretty. Everything about them is just so wow, and they're highly resistant because I wore these in Napa Valley, and I even wore them on the hot air balloon and things like that, and they held up under all of the circumstances. They are not scuffed, they're not scratched, they're still shiny, they're still beautiful, the crystals are still gorgeous, they're the most comfortable shoe ever to run around in, they look so elegant, they're so classy. Alright guys, you get the picture. I would definitely buy these again. I would buy them in more colors. And if they should ever wear out, I would get another pair. This is one of the best things I bought, and I'm so happy that I did. All right, friends, let us hear it for the jewelry segment. Okay, so as you know, I am a jewelry fanatic. I love, love, love jewelry. So in 2021, my goal was to add more rings to my collection. I had a nice bracelet stack going and several other things, and I just felt like my hands could use a little bit of jazz, a little bling, and so I ventured into adding rings to my collection. You guys know my Tiffany ring video is available on that. I also have a video on all the rings I bought in 2021, and you can check out those videos for more details. But this one is my David Yurman Renaissance ring. It is absolutely gorgeous. I love that it matches my David Yurman cable bracelet. Mine is in the pave with 18 karat gold. Love that ring. Also, the David Yurman pinky ring. This is such a beautiful ring. This one is my Roberto coin, Love in Verona. It is in diamonds and 18 karat gold. It matches my Roberto coin bracelet, which is also the Love in Verona in 18K and diamonds. And all of my jewelry, guys, is in my jewelry playlist. I have playlist detailing all of the jewelry that I own. I also have other playlists for bags, one for shoes, one for my hair. So whatever it is that you are into, I have made it easy for you to find those topics. So please look out for my anniversary birthday video. My anniversary and birthday are in 2 days, on Friday, January 7th. We are going to have a staycation. I will vlog and upload that soon. Also, as I said, up next, I am going to film my 2022 luxury wish list, so you can check that out. I will upload it maybe 3 days after this video. And then we're gonna unbox our 2022 luxury haul. So definitely look out for all of those. Thank you for supporting my channel. Thank you for being here. Happy 2022. See you, friends, in another video. I hope you enjoyed my 2021 luxury purchases. Let me know what your favorites were in the comments. See you guys next time.